Hello, welcome to Martinmade. My name is Stephanie, and today I'm going to be giving you 5 tips and tricks that you can use for your Kitchenaid. Okay guys, so here's my KitchenAid. This is where I normally store it, right here, just right in the corner. And I love having this out on the counter because I use it on a very regular basis, probably just about every meal, supper that I make, we are using our KitchenAid in some way or another, whether it's prep for supper or for bread for the week. I use my KitchenAid a lot, and so I have found a few things that have really helped me with using it even more, just broadening my horizons with it, if you will. And so there's a few things that I'm going to share with you first that have to do with the storage of it, and then I'll get into the things at the end with the use of it, the way that I have found to be very useful in our family. So, the first thing I have found with the KitchenAid is the cord. The cord was quite a hassle. It was always hanging out and it was always in the way. And when I'd go to wipe the counters, it would be in the way all the time. And so I wanted to figure out something that I could do with the cord. Now, I had considered putting a command strip right on the wall behind and just hanging the cord there. But then I had seen quite a few months back, I had seen someone that just took the same idea, but they put the command strip on the KitchenAid itself. So that's what I did. I just took a command strip, I put it on the KitchenAid, and this is a more recent thing, but I absolutely love it because wherever you go with the KitchenAid, the cord doesn't have to be pulled off of the wall. Like when I was thinking having it here, I was thinking it then is on the wall and then you have to take it off, you know, pull it off the hook in order to move it, and that's kind of going to be a pain at times. And so the thought of just having it there where I could move it right along with the KitchenAid was one of the ideas I loved. And so that has been really nice. Now, the other thing with storage that I find people really struggle with are the beaters. Now, the beaters are, it comes with 3 beaters, at least mine did. And the beaters are great, but I don't necessarily want to have to pull all the beaters out of the bowl in order to use it. So this is what I have found works amazing. As you can see, I have my beater bars here. I have my dough hook, my beater that came with it, and then I got this beater as well. This is actually plastic. Sorry about the lighting. It's really hard because there's a window right there. And then it's got the rubber tip on it. This is amazing for dough, like cakes, and even biscuits on the early stage. But this is where I store my beaters, right here on some command hooks. And when I need them, I just open the door and pull it off and put it on. So those are the 2 tricks with the storage of my KitchenAid. Now the next thing that I find is, I have found over the years, is to make butter with my KitchenAid. So that's what I'm gonna do right now. So I take my beater blade with the silicone edge, I add it onto my KitchenAid, and then I usually just use whatever whipping cream I have left. I like to add a little bit of salt to it, and then you blend it and blend it and blend it until it starts splashing buttermilk everywhere. And then you know it has separated. This is when I usually drain off the buttermilk and blend it for a little bit more just to get off any more buttermilk that might be left in there, and then drain it again, and then basically I mix it until I don't get buttermilk anymore.
And there you have it, butter.
With your KitchenAid, there are a couple of other things that you can do when you're cooking. And one of the things I like to do is I like to shred chicken, whether it's for taco meat or whether it's for another casserole or whatnot. This is actually turkey, but I'll shred turkey, I'll shred chicken, I'll shred, I'll even do beef in here. And so it's a great way to just shred it right up. And so all you do is you take and you would switch out your beater to the metal one. I use the metal one for this. I just want a good shred. And so I'll take the meat. This is great when you're having tacos, especially shredded chicken tacos. And so you take your meat, pour it in. Make sure it's locked, and then I usually put it a couple up, like maybe two or three. And you can almost get your chicken to a fine powder. And so there you go. We live up in Canada, and it is actually cheaper a lot of times to purchase just blocks of cheese. And so we will buy huge blocks of cheese from Costco, and then we have to shred it. Now, for years we had a hand shredder. Well, when I got my KitchenAid, one of the first things I wanted was a shredder for my KitchenAid. And so my husband purchased this shredder for me. I believe they look quite a bit different now. I believe you feed it through the top now as opposed to through like the way that you feed it this way on the side, kind of on the side. I believe it just kind of comes right up the top. So this is what I got for my KitchenAid, and I just take the top right off. You take out your beater, whatever one you have, and then you use the bowl and you put your it right up on there, clicks right in, you screw this in, and you have a shredder. Now, the one thing I love about this is I hate shredding, and so when we got this, it was a lifesaver. I've never had to shred by hand again. So you take your cheese, put it in, turn it on. And then you have cheese. I will let you go, and I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up. And for those of you who are new to this channel, you can hit that red subscribe button down below. I always enjoy hearing from you in the comment section as well. Let me know what some other tips are that maybe I didn't share today that you always use your KitchenAid for. I hope you are having a wonderful day, and I will see you next time. Bye!